All right, so you're action blocked on Instagram and you don't know when it's going to come off. Your growth is stopped and your Instagram marketing business is at a standstill. Here's the safe settings you can use on Jarvee that you have been waiting for. Coming up. Guys, welcome back to the channel. Art Bolesky here, the Tattooed Entrepreneur. And if this is your first time stumbling onto the channel, here on this channel, we talk digital marketing, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, growing a following, how to make money online. So if that's the type of stuff you're interested in, please consider subscribing, like the video down below. If you found value in it, leave a comment, join the discussion, and stick around for future videos. Listen, we haven't even gotten into Facebook or any of the YouTube marketing stuff that I planned on getting into. We've kind of just been doing the whole Instagram thing because there's been tons of stuff going on. So if you're excited for that stuff coming up, don't worry, I got it coming. But today's video is just reaching out to all of you who have been messaging me about the recent Instagram update. Just a quick run over. Instagram updated their algorithm, likes, action blocks across the board. Everybody's blocked. Everybody's going nuts. Nobody knows when it's going to come off. All right. One thing I can tell you, it will come off. You might have to wait 30 days. You might have to wait 2 weeks. It might come off 24 hours from now. It will come off. For those of you messaging me, asking me when it's going to come off, I do not have that answer for you. I'm still blocked myself. I've been blocked for like a week and a half. I know somebody that was blocked for a month and theirs just came off. So it will come off. You have to be patient. During this time, you should be focusing on other things. You know, Instagram isn't only the way to grow your business. It's not the only way to promote your Instagram doing follow and unfollow. There's tons of other options. All right. So listen, let's get into it. I don't want to talk you guys. Now, what I want to talk about right now is that Jarvee has actually released a state about what has gone on. I'm not going to read that to you. I'm just going to link it below. You guys are free to read that. You know, it's kind of just a general statement. It just kind of explains to you what's going on, gives you some other ways you can grow your Instagram accounts. And it's actually a pretty cool statement by Jarvee, I think, even though it doesn't give us the meat and potatoes that we want. But it's nice that they at least updated us. So listen, let's jump into the computer. I'm going to give you the settings I've been using on new accounts. Keep in mind, this is for new accounts that you've been plugging in. It is really tough now to automate an account. When you take on a client, you need to know what they've been doing for the last 30 days, because since Instagram has lowered the actions to 6,000 a month, it's what we think anyways, you need to know how many people they've been following. And one way you can kind of get a grip on that is to look at their followers. If they're following 6,000 people, then you need to be really careful. And you need to explain to them. We need to start off very slow. I need to know how many people you've been following. And you need to explain to them that while your program is running, they're not supposed to be following. That's a big thing, because you know clients are going to get mad if you get their account blocked, okay? They don't understand it like we understand it. People are emotional, especially when they're new to things, all right? Make sure you do your due diligence on the people you're signing up for automation. Don't just go getting people's accounts blocked. You know, there's a few people that I want to get accounts blocked for, but you know, I'm not that kind of guy. So top of the computer, let's figure it out. Show you guys these new settings that I've been using. They've been working for about a week. I've had no issues. All right, so let's hop in. All right, guys, so we're gonna jump into this as we're starting up a new account. So I'm gonna go right from the add profile screen, show you all the settings you need to do, a few tweaks, especially to the profile settings that you're gonna need to pay attention to. I'm not gonna go through the whole Jarvee thing. So if you're new to Jarvee, if you're just finding this video and don't know what Jarvee is, or I'll put a card up in the right-hand corner right now. You can click on that. That's the full Jarvee tutorial. I'm not going to go through a full Jarvee tutorial here. I'm just going to give you guys the settings. There's a lot of experienced people that are already following the channel that they just want the settings. So that's what I'm doing right now. So let's go through it as if I'm starting up a new profile from scratch. All right. So go to add profile. Now this is going to be my main account, Tattooed Entrepreneur. I'm just going to go through this quickly. Okay. So the Tattooed Entrepreneur. All right, so add your profile settings like such. Verify that. If you're in the local area with Jarvee, it'll just validate it automatically. If you're setting up a client account, it's gonna ask for an email verification. You need to have your client verify that email and give you the activation code so you can log into the account, okay? You also need to set up a proxy at this time. Find out the location of the account you're gonna be running. Find a location on highproxies.com. I'm gonna link that below. Very good proxies. They've just revamped their system and given a bunch of new ones. They're really taking care of that on their end. I've never had any issue with high proxies other than a few not working every once in a while, but if you email their support, they get back to you really quick and they'll give you a new one. Okay, so set up your proxy, get the account verified. All right, so one of the major changes in the advanced profile settings is the fact that we are no longer going to be using the embedded browser. So when you come down to show advanced profile settings, you're going to enable night mode. Now, the night mode I'm using right now is 2 a.m. to 7 a.m. All right, just switching up things a little bit.
All right, so 2 a.m. to 7 a.m. Enable night mode, Sunday through Saturday. Go down right here. You're going to make sure you click on Do Not Reset IDs when changing the account proxy. Do not use embedded browser to log into Instagram. And do not use embedded browser to follow on Instagram, okay? Before, we were running the embedded browser to follow. We were running the embedded browser when we were action blocked. We're not going to do that this time. So make sure Reset IDs is checked. Do not use the embedded browser to log into Instagram is checked. Do not use embedded browser to follow on Instagram. Make sure that's checked. Go down here to your API settings. Check this. Use API to save bandwidth, okay? We're going to be doing that many follows, so it's a good thing. Abort your search after 90 minutes, and that's it. So you're welcome to look at these settings and adjust them on yours as you go along. All right, now jumping into the follow tab. These are your new super targeted options. Now, it's better now to use a sniper approach versus the shotgun approach that we've been using. So instead of just randomly following 800 to 1,000 people, you know, 400 people a day, we are going to super target our sources because we are only going to be following around 190 to 200 people a day. We're going to stay under the 2,000 or the 6,000 a month follow limit. So we're going to get super targeted in our sources, all right? And these are the options that I'm using that have been super targeted, okay? You're going to wait between 40 and 70 minutes before each new operation. Follow between 20 to 30 people per operation with a delay of 60 to 180 seconds between each follow. Right off the bat, this is giving you 150 follows a day. It works out to about 190 once we adjust the settings below. I'm executing this between 8 a.m. and 6 p.m. This is because we are no longer going to run the follow at the same time as we run the unfollow. So the follow is going to execute between 8 a.m. and 6 p.m. And you'll see when the unfollow is going to execute when we get to that tab. No random sleep times. Now we are going to follow 25 to 50 people to start off. Increase daily by 25 until it reaches a maximum follows of 190. We're going to follow 15 to 25 per hour. Increase daily by 5 until it gets to 25. Okay, that's it. 25 an hour, no more than that. Scroll down here. Now these are the filters I'm using. It's all subjective. There's a few things that you should be following. You know, I skip non-English users, I speak English. If you speak another language, you're looking for Spanish speaking or any other type of language, obviously don't click that. So be subjective down here. Now, skip non-English users, check. User has a profile image, check. User has a minimum post of 100, check. User has a number of follower followings in a specific range, 50 to 1,000, all right? That's gonna keep people engaged in your content because they're not gonna be following that many people. And they're not going to have that many followers. So they're either new to Instagram. They're not that, you know, they're just a consumer on Instagram. So you want people that are going to consume your content. And this is exactly the settings we're going to use to do that. User is not following you, obviously. Skip accounts with a website. Skip business accounts. You're going to want that clicked. Do not follow accounts with more than 6 digits in their username. Generally, those accounts are spam. We are no longer liking users' latest posts, okay? So we're keeping the like tool to a minimum. All right, and that's gonna be it for your follow settings, all right? Make sure your sources are super targeted. Hashtags, people that are engaging with content in your niche, of course. Now let's go down to the unfollow setting. Follow users after a minimum of 0.75 to 1.2 days after the application followed them. Wait between 45 and 70 minutes before each new operation. Unfollow between 30 and 40 peoples per run with a delay of 30 to 140 seconds between each unfollow. Execute between 6 p.m. and 1 a.m. Remember, we're not running the follow and follow at the same time. So from 6 p.m. to 1 a.m., that's when this program is going to be unfollowing people to be more human-like. You know, nobody unfollows and follows at the same time 200 people in, you know, 6 hours. So keep them separate. All right, big thing. Keep them separate or I'll knock you out. Days of the week when to operate, Sunday through Saturday. All right, so here's your unfollow limits. Unfollow 25 to 50 per day. Increase daily 25 until it reaches 190. Unfollow 10 to 20 per hour. Increase daily by 5 until it reaches 30. Enable automatic follow unfollow. Stop unfollow tool when having less than about 1,100 to 1,300 followings. Okay, generally like to keep mine around there. Yours could be lower. It's up to you. All right, check. Or when there are no more users to follow, okay? So we're going to stop the unfollow tool when there's no more users to follow. A little bit safer of a setting. Unfollow all users followed by Jarvee. I've been running this now. My followings were getting too cluttered. You know, I got enough followers where I don't really need to focus on keeping engaged users. If they unfollow me, so be it. All right, so that's the settings I'm using now for the unfollow tab. Skip the wait time when no more results. Now, to the like, we are going to wait between 40 and 70 minutes per each operation. Like between 50 and 30 posts per operation, with a delay between 60 and 180 seconds between each like. Execute between 8 a.m. It just shows Instagram that during these hours we're active. It's when a normal human being is active, right? Unless you're a night owl. Days of the week when I operate, Sunday through Saturday. Increase actions daily by zero, blah, 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 blah. Like limits, like 25 to 50 per day. Increase by 25 until it reaches 350 max likes per day. With these settings, you're obviously only still going to be doing 135 likes a day, about 14 likes an hour. Super safe, super targeted, all right? With everybody being blocked, automating account, I think will net you better results now because there's going to be less people automating. People are going to get tired. They're just going to quit. That's going to leave you with these settings now to go out and grow your Instagram at a slower rate, but at a more targeted rate, which is good. You want a targeted following. You want a targeted audience. Like user's most recent post, limit the maximum number of likes per user to one. Skip non-English users. Make sure the user has a profile image. User is not following this account. User has a minimum of 9 posts. It's going to keep you away from the spam accounts. User has a minimum of 9 posts. Skip accounts with a website. Skip business accounts. Choose a random post from the most recent user's posts. And skip wait time when no more results. Now guys, here's where you could throw some other options in here. I've been utilizing the direct message tool to kind of message new followers, just thanking them for following. Link out to your business website, link out to your YouTube. Build relationships with people now. The fact that you can't unfollow and follow 1,000 people a day now, start building real relationships with your followers, all right? Now listen, I'm getting hundreds of messages on Instagram and YouTube. You know, I can't respond to all of you, all right? I try, but it's really getting to the point where I can't respond to all of you. You know, hundreds and hundreds of messages, it's hard to say the same thing to each person. If you are looking for an Instagram consultation, if you are looking for me to grow your Instagram account on Jarvee because you don't want to do it or you're scared, I'll link my Fiverr below. I take all payments and everything through there. So if you want to hire me or you just want a consultation, you want to do a Skype call, you just want to text me, I will link that below. Obviously, you're going to have to pay. Time is money. My time is valuable. And I have a lot going on, so if you want me to reply and talk to you and do all that, I'm honestly going to have to limit it to the people that pay for a consultation. So I'll link that below. I hope you guys are crushing it out there. Take this time while you're blocked to focus on some other things. Find some new avenues that I'm going to teach you in the next couple of weeks to grow your Instagrams, grow your Facebooks, you know. Use this to experiment with Facebook ads. Send out some story ads, you know. Facebook story ads are high converting. You know, maybe not for followers. They work for followers, but as far as, you know, sending people to your landing pages, sending people to your click funnels. So guys, focus on some other things while this is going on. The block will come off. So stay patient. Don't get too bent out of shape. All right. Keep subscribed to this YouTube channel. Make sure your notifications are on so that you stay tuned for future videos. And guys, I will see you on the next video.